see into my soul. So when somebody calls you the millennial chorus, push on.
Oh, I like it.
My name is Mr. B, the Gentleman Rhymer. I'm here at Kendal Calling on my mission to reconnect hip-hop and its ilk to the Queen's English. I'm presenting a little dose of chap-hop to people this weekend.
Now I'm checking out some crucial electro. I heard a voice that left me next to me. It was the voice of an elf of a lower past, but it reminded me of someone here from my past. I said, I've got it at last. This absolute ass came bottom in our Latin class. The really seemed John Westwood, that was his name. I'm afraid his vocal cords have gone quite lame. His enunciation is enough to disgrace, dropping T's and R's all over the place. This can't be that quiet vicar's son who had awful trouble trying to pick a chum when the quick would run and leave him sickening up. Now he's talking in my radio about dropping bombs. What another happened to Timothy? I was a prep with him, you see. We used to call him Spaz. Now he's on air chatting to Naz. He was a whiz with a cricket bat. But he never used to talk like that. He didn't though, and now he appears to talk like this.
Understand, which was this? Don't like dirty
rhyme. We're after it now. Right, then here we go, take one out, okay. Anyone. Okay, have a look at it, show the camera. Excellent. Have you ever picked a card for me before?
I haven't, no.
You haven't? Okay, in my pocket I have got somewhere a permanent marker. If I can find them. There we go. Just sign your name across the front of it.
Okay.
Excellent.
Okay.
And place the cap back on. Cool. Right then. Place it on top. And you've never picked a card for me before, you've never signed a card for me before. This is completely free choice of a playing card.
It is indeed.
Okay, hold both hands out for me. Now we'll start with a little warm-up trick before we get onto the other ones, and all we've got to do is make it jump back to the top again like that. So cards for Mr. B written across it. If we take this card, place it on your hand, place your hand on top and squeeze down tight. Excellent. If we take an indifferent card of, say, the Queen of Clubs, All we've got to do is take the Queen of Clubs and wave it over the top like that, and you see your card jumps out. Look in your hand. Queen of Clubs.
Okay. I think I'll try some of that crack cocaine. I heard it rather takes away the pain. It's the kind of caper that might get me in the papers and garner me some critical acclaim. I'll make myself a nice drug hell. A cheeky tale the press can tell. And if I smoke some crack, I might get my measure back.
It's been terribly pleasant so far. I played the Freak Easy last night, which was most pleasant, and I'll be playing at the, whatever it's called, the Soapbox, I think it is, this afternoon. So, yes, looking forward to that. Should all be a lot of fun.
Straight out of Surrey, a gentleman rhymer named Mr. B, a pleasure with chat, but with an air of mystery. When I'm poised to be sad, I put some moist shag, squeeze it out of high, but declare it was a voice brag. But be so proud if you dine with me, looking stabbingly, popping for the swifty. Doff my hat, but for the party when I'm going out, reach the 2,000 on my cash if you're going out. Please don't rumble, try to act humble, you embarrass yourself when you rumble. Going on about your mother like this, with the hat with the bad jaunty angle, and the shag is so smooth, I got a chair by the fire so I shuffle. Talk of murder, that's so tawdry, I have a crime record like Charles Hawtrey.
Are you performing tonight? Or are you performing at
no,
all?
No, I'm kind of... I've performed about an hour or so ago.
Okay. Well, are you sticking around?
Yes, I'm around tonight.
And what if I put be crazy news to get you on the mic during my set? Is that, do we think that's...
I think that's a good idea.
No, let me smoke my pipe off the top of the dome.
Yes, what the, my version, my yeah. one. Yeah, absolutely.
Shall yeah. I find out if there's a mic? Because I've got just 900 go. Number, it would work with just that, wouldn't it?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. yeah.
Just, I'm going to go and ask.
You can keep that playing card.
Oh, that's very nice. I'll have that for good luck.
So, yeah.
Chab Hobbs, basically, if you can imagine Chuck D, Teddy Thomas, and George Formby having a sweet sherry in the club somewhere in Mansion House. Something around about there, really, you'll be looking at.
The sun goes down, and there's still no cream. And four more biscuits make their ruddy scream. They break in the teacup again and again. And sometimes they have to stay up till ten. On a crazy, 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 crazy night.
Sing it!
On a crazy, 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 crazy night.
You really have to sing it now. Let's go!
So what's this one you've been filming here?
This is it's a new one, it's off the next album, it's called Shoot the Cuff.
Right.
And it's a bit more of a, it's like, almost like a kind of big beating thing.
Really?
I mean, in the headphones.
Taking it up a
great.
Notch. Take it up
Take
a notch.
Take it up a notch. Well, you know, it's got to be a bit of light and shade.
What's happening with he's getting back with two gigs then?
I think so, yeah. Well, it was my birthday the other day, it was a couple of months ago, and my wife got in touch with him and just said, I mean, we're still all in touch, but she just said, look, yeah. It's Jim's 40th, and why don't you come along and you know, we can get the band back together and things like that. So,
that'd be brilliant.
But yeah, they did a little bit of rehearsing and what have you. Yeah, it was good.
That's so good! Send that to You've Been Framed!
Pay close attention. Pay close attention. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been missing being the gentleman right now.
Welcome, Mr. B. Better bust a move, or you'll be just up to it, a mention of your life, and I'll say to the doorman.